What's up everyone, I am back today, and before you start watching this video, it is important that you watch the Endless guide that I made a couple of days ago. This is not a video to learn about Endless in general, but only a guide about team building that completes the other video. Okay, so your team starts with understanding your situation. Do you have a heavy carry that can clear the game by itself for the first 2000 to 2000 floors? Something like Reshiram, Zacian, Zekrom, Kyogre, Groudon, Mewtwo? No? Okay. Do you have an Ultra Beast or something similar that has good stats and good moves, like Kartana, Naganadel, Regidrago? No? Okay. Do you have an okay to good Pokemon with good egg moves that can carry something better later on, like a Gligar with Stonax and Earthquake, or something similar, to, for example, carry a Tinkaton? No? Alright. Do you have a Technician Meowth and a Magikarp? Probably. And if you don't, well, it is time to go farm and then come back. Before we move on to the next phases of the video, let me tell you how to choose a carry for your first set of floors all the way to 2000 or more. It can be something as low cost as Weedle transforming into a Mega Beedrill, Flinch Machine with King's Rock and Multilens and Pin Missile, all the way to monsters like Primal Kyogre or Reshiram. It all starts in the base stats and potential moveset. The reason Kyogre is so insane is because of his base stats being very high and his insane moveset at the beginning. Origin Pulse being a spread 110 stab move, keeping in mind that you are permanently into the rain because of his ability, is insane. It doesn't really lose in power because not only does he learn moves like Ice Beam and Water Spout, but he can transform into his primal form, giving him even more stats. So Mega Beedrill, Gyarados or any Flinch strats are also good choices, but they are not very strong from the start since you need those items to work. So it all depends on what you have. It is up to you to think about which Pokémon are good for the early part of the game. Look up each Pokémon. Do they have good stats? Do they have good movesets? If they have good stats but bad movesets, do they have good egg moves? If yes, do good stats and good moves or movesets? Then it is probably a good choice. Look at the ability as well. The reason I'm saying that the Ultra Beasts are good is because they can self-enhance themselves, or Pokemons like Magearna is good too because they have Soul Art. So there is also stuff like Regidrago, for example. It is an insane Pokemon to carry you because he has a huge HP pool and he has Dragon Energy at level 66. The only problem is that you need to get to level 66 for that to work. So solutions. His aim moves are not that bad. You have Flamethrower, Meteor Mash, Dragon Dart that can help you a great deal in the early game. If you don't have aim moves, get the Pokerus to boost your EXP and a couple of good early Pokemons like Nimble to carry his big ass to level 66. And that's it. Once you are level 66, all you have to do is focus on your Regidrago, get him all the candies, and you just have to spam Dragon Energy. It is as easy as that. Like I said earlier, any big legendary with good stats and moves are good. Ultra Beast with good stats and good movesets works too. Stuff like Kartana, Naganadel. I'm saying this again, but it can be anything. Look into what you have. Check the movesets, base stats, egg moves to determine if the Pokemon can be good later on. Then go and test it yourself on the ground. And be sure to actually go into floors like 250, 300, 400. Because you can be unlucky early on and have some bad matchups. It can happen before your Pokemon actually gets good. Don't give up. For example, right now I am playing a Latias with stored power. It was a pretty bad early game, but now we are just cruising through the game. So I might post a tier list at some point, but it is going to be very, very far in the future. So depending on what you have, your team building is going to be different, but really not that different. I'm not going to make four different teams, but instead I'm going to take the second best case scenario because most of the time you will have access to one of those after finishing Classic. So Kartana, Naganadel, Regidrago, or any of the beasts, to be honest, or any of those 5, 6, 7 cards that are pretty strong. You have a lot of different choices. You can just check the different movesets and the base stats. Of course, if you have a legendary, it is going to be way easier. So let's start by adding our carry to the team. In my case, I'm going to choose Kartana. Keep in mind that having all our Pokémon shinies is preferable but not necessary. So what do we need next? Since we do not have a very bulky Pokémon, we need to have something that completes Kartana or something to run away with. In my case, since I have a low-cost shiny Rattata, this is what I'm going for. I repeat what I said earlier, you do not need the Pokémon to be shiny, but it is better. Note that if you have a legendary, you can probably skip the runaway Pokémon, but you will have to capture it later on. So we now have 4 slots left. A pickup Pokémon is essential since you can grab items from wild Pokémon. It does not matter if you have a legendary as a starter or something else. In my case, I have a rare shiny Zigzagoon, so this is my choice, but you can grab whatever you have available with pickup. 3 slots left. For your next slot, I've been told that taking the Pokérus could be great. I personally never take it and I'm more than fine, but it could be helping your case if you have a weak early game. Feel free to fill your team with whatever you have available. Pokémons like Nimble and Meowth can be a great help early on and in double battles because they can either flinch or just deal a great amount of damage, so I suggest taking one of them. Nimble evolves at 24 and has 2 stabs prior moves being Sucker Punch and First Impressions. They can easily sweep most of the early game, even the Paradox Pokémons. Meowth with Technician uses Fake Out and Feint at the beginning but can generate a good amount of money with Payday. I'm going to fill the rest of the team with the highest shiny Pokémon I can find, and before we move on with this team, I'm going to make a quick one for people that are maybe new to the mod. You can go with Magikarp for the later fusion, right, and get some kind of flinch strat with Bite and Multi-Lenses, it can actually work. You have then Meowth and Nimble, can be very good for the early game carry of the game, so you have Meowth on one side and Nibble on the other side, 2 very very strong early Pokémon, Zigzagoon for pickup, Rattata for runaway, and finally a Weedle, so you can have a Pin Missile Weedle for the flinch strat, or you can have, a Pin Missile Weedle, a Pin Missile Beedrill, or Mega Beedrill, or you can have a Mega Gyarados with a Bite flinch strat. It is up to you. You can do whatever you want. I would say that Mega Beedrill is probably better, better for the flinch strat, but Gyarados is just overall better for the most of the game. Of course, your main carry is gonna be Magikarp or Weedle, and the rest is basically utility and early carry. So we're gonna go with the team that I have on the screen right now. We are going to start at 1 to 250. Alright, so let's talk about flinch for double battle in general. This is very optional, but when you have a main carry and you go into a double battle, you can definitely have your secondary Pokémon have a priority move that flinch the one that you are not currently killing. This is actually pretty important because later on, everything can one-hit you. Something like Fake Out or any multi-hit move with King's Rock and Multi-Lens. I think the most common one those days is going to be Water Shuriken because it can touch both of them. It is a multi-hit move as well. So it is not strictly necessary, but it is a good quality of life to have. So we're gonna start moving to the floors, fighting double battles, paradox bosses, struggling or not. At this point, there is really nothing to do when it comes to team building. Keep investing on your main carry, you might get your form, you might get some good vitamins, multi-lens, King's Rock, but nothing really special. You probably won't get any DNA splicers either to fuse your shiny together for luck points, so you have really no free slot. And if you do, you can always potentially get a Garganacle that you meet on your way, because it is pretty strong against Eternatus and for the dot part, or you know, any kind of fairy or steel type to cheese Eternatus. After that, we have 251 to 1000. So during this period, you might find your first DNA splicer. So merge your luck fillers together, so those shiny Pokémon, even if those are very simple shinies, you can still merge them together. And I'm gonna say this for the last time, it does not matter if you don't have any shinies, you still need to make some slots for your team because you need those slots to merge Pokémon together. So remove Meowth or remove Nimble at this point, but just remove one of your Pokémon to make some space. During the end part of this phase, so around 1000, your carry should be established with his form. TMs, all of his berries, and a couple of items. So if you play a flinch strat and you feel like you can't lose, keep in mind that you need a strat for Eternatus in his Emax form because you cannot flinch him. I'm just gonna repeat this just in case. So there is no way to direct yourself to specific biomes in Endless because there is no map, or not yet anyways. You have to take things as they come. So sometimes you might not find what you want and you have to deal with that. Alright, so how to deal with 1k, 2k Eternatus if you have some kind of flinch strat? You can take down anything besides Eternatus every 1000 floors because he is immune to flinching. The only way to deal with that is to build a Pokemon dedicated to dotting him. So build a steel slash fairy type with residual damage only. So moves like Salcure, Leech Seed, Curse, etc. So if you're wondering how, just follow the part of the video talking about the dot strat and how to build a team with it, then keep using your flinching Pokemon for the rest of the game. So the reason I said that Garganacle is a very popular choice for Eternatus is because you can apply Salt Cure. It is a strong residual damage that can just be applied to Eternatus and then you can switch onto your main carry to finish him off. If you are using a Steel type, it is actually very easy to take down Eternatus. Make sure that your main carry has Protect, and then all you have to do is apply Salt Cure, go into your main Pokemon and alternate between your main ability and Protect because the only move that he has against you is going to be Eternabeam, which recharge after each use. This is why I will not use a Fairy only type in that case because all he's gonna use is his Poison move since he cannot use Eternabeam. Eternabeam is a Dragon move which does nothing into Fairy, so he's just gonna spam X-Cross or Sludge Bomb. It is either going to be a Steel only type that uses Protect every 2 turns or a strong Steel slash Fairy type that can out damage his healing and his plus 6 defense slash special defense. So overall, not really any big changes when it comes to your team besides them evolving in their own way and having a free slot that you can fill for something to deal with Eternatus, which should be the biggest danger at this point. Alright, so good job, you made it to past 1000. It is a pretty big deal, to be honest. Not that big if you have the good strats for it, of course. At this point, you should have all your amulet coins, your luck capsule, and a way to reroll at least 1 to 3 times each round. We can potentially fish for whatever we need and splice all the Pokémon in our team. So around this point, your main can start to fall off a bit, but it's time to start building our second carry. And we need to think about it after floor 1000. So let's start talking about potential team change and start with the carry. So keep in mind that it is not recommended to switch to your second carry below, I would say, 2000 to 2500. We are just preparing for the future here. Most of the time, your main carry should be able to pull off killing until 2000 to 2200. Some of them can even go as high as 3000. Like it was the case for my Tinkaton in my last run. There is really only 3 ways to play in the late game. You can have dots, you can have counter damage, or you can have fixed level damage. I'm going to explain the playstyle for each setup. So dots. You play with a mix of Soak, Salt Cure, Leech Seed, Curse, and Super Fang. Super Fang is very important if you're gonna play dots only. So you're gonna put those on multiple Pokémons, of course. Most of the time, you want to have them on 2 to 3 Pokemon. I would say 2, not really 3. To 2 to 3 of those moves on 2 Pokemon and have a Pokemon with like either Sturdy or Wonder Guard with Super Fang. So you need to basically dot, switch to your wall, and then kill with Super Fang. That's the play here. Alright? The gameplay is very straightforward. You start off on your first Pokemon. You can have, for example, Soak and something like Curse, for example. So use your first dot or Soak to change to the water type. Then Curse, you either die or switch. And I'm talking about very high bosses here, stuff like Eternatus. If you do not have a very high boss, you can definitely just stay on your wall, put 2 dots and spam Super Fang. You don't really have to do anything else. But I'm gonna explain this later on because this is the strat I'm gonna pick in this case. After that, we have fixed level damage. So we want to play with moves that scale based on your level. There is only 2 of them that can do this. It is Seismic Toss and Nightshade. If you are going to use fixed level damage, it is time to start looking for candy jars as soon as possible because you're going to need those levels to keep up with the damage past floor 2500, where the resistance and the damage of the enemy are getting very high because of the tokens. So this is probably the worst strat out of the three, I would say, because you need to keep killing past 3000 to stay up in levels. So this strat is actually used a lot in the mid game, I would say, after 2500, and people usually switch to dot or counter damage, but since I actually seen people pull off wave 5850 and go to crazy levels in the endgame, I'm actually running this as a potential strat. The gameplay is not complicated, you keep leveling, you're going to outspeed no matter what since you are going to be way higher level than them, you use Seismic Toss or Nightshade and you win. Keep in mind that you can dodge annoying fights by using your fastest Pokémon or your runaway Pokémon in this case, since some enemies can be immune to those damage. For example, if you use Nightshade, normal types are gonna be immune, or if you use Seismic Toss, ghost types are gonna be immune. Next, we have counter damage. So those are gonna play with moves that reflect damage back to the opponents, so moves like counter, mirror coat, metal burst, come up ends. So those damage are gonna scale with your HP, so the more damage you take, the more you reflect. Each move has its ups and downs. Counter and mirror coat have negative priority, so you do not need a negative spin nature, but you need to know what type of move is coming, physical or special. Metal burst and come up ends do not have negative priority, which means that you actually need a negative spin nature and Suldus to use those moves. You're always gonna go second. You are going to be prone to status conditions token. So if you are asleep, frozen, or sometimes paralyzed, you cannot use those moves. This is why you need Citrus Berries, 4 leftovers, and a sturdy ability, and protect to spam your counter ability and get back to full HP to reactivate sturdy every single time. Now, for the status conditions, what you could potentially do is having a Pokemon like Wormadam or Dugtrio that has the sturdy ability as a passive, and then get something like Good as Gold or Purifying Salt that immunes your Pokemon to status conditions, and then you should be fine for a very long time. But most of the time, you are going to go for a very large HP pool Pokemon like Blissey or, you know, Avalug or stuff like that, and then fuse them into a Pokemon that has Sturdy and Metal Burst, or just make a fusion of multiple Pokemons. But most of the time, you're not gonna have a mix of Sturdy and a status immune ability. So you will need to basically find a Pokemon that can have Misty Terrain that would basically just put the Misty Terrain on the field to immune your Pokemon to status condition. You can even have the actual move on your main Pokemon. That would be a great way to go about it as well, right? You can have basically Metal Burst, Misty Terrain, Protect, and then something else. That would be the play. This way you don't have to deal with status conditions and you don't have to deal with switching as well. It is a potential strat for this specific strat too. So the gameplay that you use depends entirely on which Pokemon you encounter. All three strats can work in their own way. I would say the best one is probably the dot one, or not the best one, but the more reliable one, right? It's definitely the dot one if you have everything that's needed. We are going to discuss all of those strats in time. For now, we're going to start with dots. Then we will move on to fixed level damage. And finally, we will have something for counter damage. And after each of those team building, I'm going to explain how to play them in the game. At this point in time, it is very important that you get at least 2 open slots in your team to start splicing the moveset together. Since we're going to go for either Wonder Guard or Sturdy, the Pokémon that's going to get the moves does not matter. Of course, it is better if you have a good typing on your Wonder Guard Pokémon like a normal slash ghost type or ghost slash dark, because those only have one weakness. So those are basically the best fusions for Wonder Guard. For the Sturdy Pokémon, you obviously need to play with Protect, and it is better most of the time if you have a positive speed. It's always better to go first. This way, we can avoid those nasty status conditions, right? In the case of dotting, right? Not in the case of metal bursting. We are talking about dotting here. Since Wonder Guard is pretty rare, I'm going to actually make a sturdy Pokemon in this case. But because we are still on the early part of 1000, your main carry can still win most of those fights, so you are free to work on this second carry in the background. This is why we need at least 2 slots in our team. What you should do is keep a couple of tabs open of those different moves that you need. You only need to think logically about those. Leech Seed is going to be found on some grass types, so pay attention in grassy biomes. Salcure is only available on Garganacle. Soak is available on water types or some water types, so pay attention in water biomes. Curse is available on some ghost types, so pay attention in the graveyard. And Super Fang is available on some Pokémon with fangs or rodents in general. You can always keep tabs open for those 5 moves and check them whenever you meet a potential candidate. The goal here is to build your wall with at least 3 of those abilities. For me, since I'm going for Sturdy, I do need to use Protect, and the Pokémon with Sturdy should always be the last to be spliced. So I'm going to add the fusion mechanics on the right side here just for clarity so you can understand, and I'm going to explain how I'm going to splice them together. As I go and do my business on my main carry, I find a Garganacle with Sturdy, teach him Salcure, then wait for the next one. A couple of floors after that, I find a Breloom, teach him Leech Seed, then fuse your Garganacle into this Breloom. Make sure you actually do it correctly and in the right order. By fusing Garganacle and Breloom, we do lose Sturdy, but since we are going to unsplice, we are actually gonna get Sturdy back. Even though we do lose the second Pokémon, we are actually gonna get the first ability back from the first Pokémon. Now I have a fusion of a Garganacle and Breloom. Let's say we find a Raticate. First, you unsplice your Garganacle. We do lose Breloom, but we get Sturdy back. Then you teach your Raticate Super Fang and Protect. Then you splice your Raticate into Garganacle. This way, we get a Sturdy Raticate with the following moveset: Salcure, Leech Seed, Super Fang, Protect. To be completely honest, you don't really need the 2 other moves except for very tough bosses like Eternatus, but we are still going to make them anyways. You need at least 1 open slot, which you should have, and you repeat the previous process. So find a Pokémon with Soak, like Lumineon for example, and splice it into an available Pokémon. In my case, I'm going to fuse it into the Pokémon with Pickup. Next, we find a Curse Pokémon. You're gonna unsplice your Lumineon in your Pickup Pokémon to get Pickup back. Then we're gonna splice the Curse Pokémon into the Pickup one to get a Soak slash Curse Pokémon with Pickup. You can always refuse those Pokémons later on into Shinies to get more luck points, so just keep that in mind. And now that the second carry is ready, there is really nothing else to do for this bracket. We have a runaway Pokémon, a pickup Pokémon, we have our first and second carry, and we have luck fillers for the rest. So shiny Pokémons for the luck points. You do not need the runaway Pokémon at this point. It is of course just a quality of life. You can capture it later, but keep in mind that you actually need it. Okay, so the splicing for fixed level damage is extremely straightforward because most of the time you want to splice your main carry into your Seismic Toss slash Nightshade Pokémon. The reason we are doing this is because your main carry is going to have all your levels and we don't want to lose those and start new. For this simulation, my main carry is going to be Kartana and I'm going to keep leveling him up to specifically prepare for this strategy. The only thing that I need is a Pokémon that has Nightshade or Seismic Toss. You can choose to add an ability like Sturdy on top of the Pokémon that has those moves to have an extra layer of protection. So let's say that for example that I'm choosing to have a Pokémon with Nightshade since it is very common, something like Dusknoir for example. I'm gonna teach Dusknoir Nightshade, then I start looking for another Pokémon that has Sturdy like Garganacle for example. In this specific case, I'm gonna teach Garganacle Salcure, then I'm going to splice Garganacle into Dusknoir to have a fusion of the 2 with Salcure and Nightshade, and then I can get Sturdy back later on when I unsplice. So remember, since you're gonna unsplice, you want your first Pokémon to have Sturdy. Otherwise, when you unsplice, you're gonna get back the other ability, which is the wrong one. So now, all I have to do is level my main carry until it does not work anymore, unsplice Garganacle and Dusknoir to get Sturdy back, then fuse Kartana into Garganacle. And now we have a fusion of Kartana and Garganacle with Salcure and Nightshade plus the Sturdy ability. So whatever happens, do not fuse into your main too early or you will lose in strength. The splicing for Metal Burst is very straightforward too because there is only one Pokémon to make. It might just be the fusion of multiple ones. So to make a counter Pokémon that works, you need 5 things. One or two counter moves depending if you go Metal Burst or counter slash Mirror Coat. Healing items to get you back to full, so Citrus Berries and 4 leftovers most of the time. And Enigma Berries as well, of course, but those make sense. Sturdy, Protect, and a lot of HP. Healing items are going to come by themselves and you can teach Protect to most Pokémons. The TM is also very common to find in the shop, it is a white one. So in this case, we only need 3 things. Metal Burst, Sturdy, and HP. Most of the time, your main Pokémon is going to be built from the ground up, just like the Dot Pokémon. Since we need a lot of HP, it is better to fuse 2 Pokémon that have a good amount of HP. That's why most people are gonna go with Blissey, but you can go for something different like Regidrago, Wobbuffet, G-Max Snorlax, or really anything with HP. In that case, I'm gonna go with Blissey. The easiest and best way to go about it is to find an Arcaludon with Sturdy because he has Metal Burst by default and a good chunk of HP. All you have to do in that case is make sure that Arcaludon has Metal Burst, then splice your Blissey into Arcaludon. You now have an HP beast with Metal Burst and Sturdy and all you need is for him to have Protect and healing items, then you are good to go. The HP that you need to clear Endless is going to have something around 300 to 400k HP. You do not need more than that. If you choose to go for the 3-part fusion, that's how you do it. So first, you're gonna find your HP beast, so Blissey in my case. After that, you're gonna find a Pokémon with Metal Burst. So let's say that I find something like a King Gambit, for example. You're gonna fuse Blissey and King Gambit to learn Metal Burst, unsplice them, then finally splice your Metal Burst Blissey into a Pokémon with Sturdy, the most common one being Garganacle. It is significantly easier to just merge an HP beast with Arcaludon since it's really not that rare to find and has everything that you need. Okay, so now that we have each team, how are we gonna play them? I'm just gonna do a recap because it is very, very easy to play. For Dots, simply stay on your main Pokémon, put your 2 Dots, then spam Super Fang. Heal if necessary using Protect. Make sure you're always full to activate Sturdy. For a big boss fight like a Paradox Pokémon or Eternatus, start off on your Pokémon with Soak and Curse, try to apply those dots, then move on to your main Pokémon, apply your dots, then spam Super Fang with Protect to get you back to full. For fixed level damage, keep using Nightshade or Seismic Toss until the enemy is dead. Keep in mind that you need to be vastly outleveling the enemies to finish Endless with that strat. Finally, for counter damage, stay on your counter Pokémon, spam Metal Burst until the enemy is dead, heal in between to make sure you are full health in order to activate Sturdy. If the enemy Pokémon applies any status condition like Freeze, Sleep or Paralyze, it can happen that you're not gonna attack since you're always gonna go second. In that case, you can have a Pokémon with a Misty Terrain that's gonna immune you to status conditions, but if you don't have those, you can just heal in between attempts and just pray that you have the good status condition like poison or just no paralyze or no status condition overall. But those are gonna happen. This is why this strat is actually pretty annoying to play with if you don't have any immune to status conditions. I'm gonna continue the video taking into account that you have the Dot team, but everything that I'm gonna say can be applied to the other 2 strats. They have the same threat because we are using Sturdy for the rest of the game. The next bracket is gonna be from 2001 to 2500, so the biggest planning of this mod is done between 1000 and 2000. If you are still not done with your second carry, now is definitely the time. You need to be done before your main carry falls off. If you are playing a Pokémon with Wonder Guard or Sturdy, there is a couple of abilities that can mess with you, and since in this case we are playing Sturdy, we need to deal with those. So we have Mold Breaker that bypass Sturdy. There is only 2 ways to deal with this. We can have Runaway, or we can learn a move like Worry Seed or Entrainment to one of our Pokémon. We have Neutralizing Gas that disables Sturdy and Runaway, so we actually need Worry Seed or Entrainment. And then finally, we have multi-hit moves that are bad against Sturdy, but do not work against Wonder Guard. So it depends in this case, obviously. So what did we learn here? We need a Pokémon with an enchantment or Worry Seed, since they can potentially mess up our strat. At this point in the game, around 2500, you do not need your pickup Pokémon anymore, since you should have all your berries and your berry pouches. This is the one we're going to replace. So once again, look up Worry Seed or Entrainment on any website, then splice him into your pickup Pokémon to get the right move. In my case, I'm probably going to go into Breloom. So now that we have Breloom with Worry Seed, you want to unsplice your Gengar and your Zigzagoon. We are gonna merge Gengar and Breloom to have Worry Seed. And after that, all you have to do is find a Pokémon with Prankster to always go first. This is very important. Not necessary, to be honest, but it is pretty important because your Pokémon is gonna be mostly underleveled, and at like 3,000, 4,000, most Pokémon are gonna be faster than you, except if you have those speed nature or the Prankster ability. So in this case, we're gonna go for Prankster. We always go first on Worry Seed or Entrainment. So something like Whimsicott or Klefki are actually pretty nice. And now that you have Klefki with Prankster, we want to merge the Gengar, so unsplice Gengar and Breloom. And now we're gonna merge Gengar into Klefki. This way we have Soak, Curse, Worry Seed, and Prankster on Gengar. And of course, since now we have Worry Seed and Prankster, we can remove those nasty abilities. At this point, the gameplay is very simple. You dot stuff, then you go to the next Pokémon. If you find something hard to kill, run away. If it's a forced battle with a Paradox Pokémon or Eternatus, check the potential ability or check the fusion of Eternatus or the Paradox Pokémon. If they have a very annoying ability like Neutralizing Gas or Mold Breaker, you want to remove the ability, right, if needed, with Worry Seed. Then you're gonna apply your Soak slash Curse onto the enemy Pokémon. And then you are gonna switch into your wall and finish it off. If you find a multi-hit move Pokémon and it is a forced battle, you're gonna have to pray for Focus Band proc because there is really nothing else you can do. And that's why Wonder Guard is probably the superior option, but it is harder to find as well. Final bracket is gonna be from 2500 to 5850. Let's do a recap for our team. We have our main carry, now obsolete, that's one. We have our second carry, that's two. We have a Prankster, Worry Seed, and two dots, that's three. We have a plus six luck filler that we fuse at the beginning, that's four. And we have a runaway Pokémon, that's fine. And finally, we have another luck filler Pokémon, that's six. Of course, this team can be different from you. If you don't have any luck fillers, you can find shinies along the way. It is definitely possible. The only thing left to do at this point is to run away and capture shinies slash legendaries with our Master Ball. The only issue left in our case is that a legendary or shiny can be found in a double battle. We could skip those shiny and legendary, since double battles are bad for Sturdy, or, you know, one of those Pokémon could have a weakness to Wonder Guard. If we do not want to give up on those potential shiny slash legendary, we can learn one of those moves. So we have Roar, Whirlwind, Circle Throw, and Dragon Tail that lets us remove the Pokémon that we do not need. So we basically teach one of those moves to one or two Pokémon, and you can obviously fuse the moves if necessary if you can't learn them by TMs. We're gonna use those Pokémon to get rid of the useless Pokémon in the double battle, and then we throw our Master Ball. Alright? So do not hesitate to throw away any unnecessary Pokémon like your first carry to get even more luck points, since we're going to mostly roll for Master Ball at this point of the game. Good job! We are done with the team building. This is the part where you, as I said, hunt for those sweet legendary and shiny, and nothing can stop you besides multi-hit moves if you are a sturdy Pokémon. So that's going to conclude this video about team building in Endless mode. I hope you enjoyed the video. I will probably focus on Endless highlights and classic run and potentially tier list in the next video. Do not hesitate to leave any comments if you have any suggestions. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!